Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco here. Hope everyone's doing great. I had a bit of a week off, so I didn't make the note-taking ranking video straight away, but today I'm going to be ranking note-taking applications. Just to note that, obviously, these are all my own opinion. The last one was good, but I changed a few things about the format of this one. So I've changed, firstly, the ranking. Whilst I'm going to talk a little bit about the future of each application, I'm not going to talk about it as a ranking option. So there is going to be 5 ranking options. Amazing, which is fantastic, like absolutely great. Great, good, average, and naff. Naff, I think, is a English term for rubbish. I don't think it's a like a actual word. So I have the note-taking apps below. One thing that I'm probably always going to get, you know, noted in the comments is I'm going to miss an application, or I'm just not going to include it. I'm going to try and get to every single application and use traditional sort of categorization for these, but they span over so many applications. There are some hybrids in here that involve 2 processes, so do bear with me, but I love to always hear yourself in the comments telling and sharing about where you think applications should be placed. So we're here with tier maker. I will include the link in the description if you did want to make your own tier maker for this one. So let's start with NotePlan. Now, NotePlan is actually in its 3rd edition. I really like the application. It's really well designed for iOS and Mac. It actually looks really attractive, but works more like a sort of blend between Agenda and Roam and Obsidian with the new addition of backlinks. It can sort of be like a home hub basis now for all of your notes, tasks, and calendar events. There are a few of these applications popping up. The likes of AmpleNote is another one, which is up next. But I'm gonna put this one inside a great because I'm really impressed with how this application has launched, how it's addressing sort of, I guess, hub productivity systems. And I feel like this is like a new space that's doing very well at the moment. Now, the same goes for AmpleNote. I'm gonna probably put this in good, only because I think their pricing's a little bit high, but I also think that they're still early days in terms of their journey. And when I used the web application, it did seem a little bit clunky on the end, whereas something like NotePlan was a bit more stable. So I'm actually going to put AmpleNote in good. However, inside of AmpleNote, I was super impressed at the task score abilities. I think that is super awesome. And something that I think even task management applications can learn from, even though it's this task calendar slash note taker, all enrolled into one. Now, next up is a friend. it's the elephant, it's Evernote. Now, you guys know that I've been using it, but back again as my sort of go-to personal note taker. And whilst I'm impressed with the 10 update, I've said publicly I'm not that happy with the bug side of stuff. It definitely does sort of take away from that consistent experience you expect with Evernote, and they do need to address it. There's a fair few bugs. I think a lot of it, it's like almost like when you land on it, it's the stability side of it, like even the note sometimes wobbles and it feels a little bit clunky. I'm sure they'll work on it. They're doing 2 weekly fixes by the looks of it, so that's not too bad. That's why I'm going to put it in good. I'm not going to give it a great, I'm going to give it an amazing. It's just good at the moment, and if you're sort of looking for my opinion, I think it's, as I said, not just there yet. So next up is Agenda Notes. So this one is something that I'm quite impressed with. It won Apple's Design Award back in 2018. It's an impressive looking application, blends calendars and notes together. And I think if you're someone that is calendar note orientated, has an iOS or Mac device, this is a really nice application because it doesn't overcomplicate things. It actually makes it quite simple as an application. We've actually got a new sort of mini course on it, which I'll link in the description, coming soon. But I would say it's definitely in the sort of good, great category. I like that it's free forever. You don't necessarily have to go up to the premium to access it. So that's pretty good in itself. And that's why I think it's great. It's a really well-built application. So next up is Bear. This is a private markdown editor, very similar to Agenda to some extent, but doesn't have these calendar abilities. Very much keeps it to notes and very simple notes tagging system to get you going. It's available, again, very Apple intensive, iOS and Mac, but I'm gonna give this one a great as well. I think this is a really well-built application and something that the team have developed nicely over the years. So now OneNote, a lot of people ask me, like, Microsoft OneNote, what are your opinions on it? I think it's a great cross-platform application alternative to Evernote. I always tend to normally recommend it for college students just because of the way that it connects with OneDrive and other such Microsoft products. However, I'm never too I'm impressed with some of the handwriting functionality in it. However, I'm never too impressed with the way that it's sort of, I guess I'm never impressed with it as a collective product. It's never something that has made it sort of an amazing experience to use. So I'm going to put in average just because I feel like it's a bit like Google Keep to some extent. It's a bit like the go-to application in the market. I'm not going to say it's like Google Keep because it's not like Google Keep. It's very much its own product, but OneNote for me is an average. Next up is Nimbus Note, and this is one that actually impressed me when I first checked it out. It definitely has stronger stability than Evernote at the moment, and it's doing very well in terms of providing a pretty intensive clip abilities, which I really like, and also some of the more advanced abilities that Evernote users have expected in the past, and a decent price as well. So at the moment, I think for the bang for your buck, value for your money, it's definitely in the great category. It's really impressed me over the last couple of months and definitely deserves to be in that category. And as you can imagine, Evernote needs to look at the application like this, but I can see Evernote sort of looking to Rome and Obsidian to sort of jump past them. But only time will tell, guys, only time will tell. Now, next up is Notion. Again, I'm really always impressed with Notion and the way they've positioned themselves in the market. I definitely think Notion is a great application. I feel like none of these are gonna go into the amazing category, but at the same time, it's something that is doing really well at the moment. It's becoming more stable, and I just think they've done well at capturing a mass market audience. You see like Instagrammers, YouTubers, and even like students, like pretty much everyone you wouldn't expect to have a note taker be able to jump on board with this one. And it's one that a lot of people have fallen into the sort of deep learning on, which is great. So that's always nice to see, especially the sort of mass market side of stuff. Next up is Obsidian. Now, I've really not invested in Obsidian because of like, in terms of my learning, I actually haven't done anything inside of Obsidian. A lot of people ask like, are you using Obsidian? No, I'm not, because I don't think it's suitable for me. However, I'm always impressed at the way they're building applications and the speed at which they're doing so. The main reason I say that is because they are doing what Rome's doing, but I would say faster to some extent, and also doing it in a free experience and focusing on the privatization of data, which is really nice in terms of having it offline in the local storage. So I'm going to go and put Obsidian as amazing. I think that it's got a really interesting next 12 months, especially because it hasn't even come out of beta yet, which is impressive at the least. So next up is actually, you can't see it on the start mode, it's Rome. I'm going to just hover over here because you can see the logo then. Again, Rome is, it has impressed me since its launch, mainly due to the fact that it's got such a cult following, people love it, and it adds features at a good rate. It also has one of those sort of teams, the development team and founder, that are so intuitive with their community that they definitely understand them and know what's going on. So that's why I'm definitely going to put it in the great category. A fair amount of them are going in the great category. Let's see what the final ones get. We've got Google Keep up next, and I'm going to immediately pop this in average because I view it sort of as OneNote. I feel like it's good if you're looking to very nicely note take lightly. It reminds me very much of having post-it notes on your phone. If you're someone that really wants that, that's where it's a good bet. However, for me, I just find it an average experience, and obviously it doesn't really go much further than you expect. Now, SimpleNote is probably in that sort of category. I rate it as naff. I just don't think it's got anything going for it necessarily. It has like the sort of basic abilities you expect with a note taker, and it is free, that's what's great about it. But at the same time, it's, you know, like Standard Notes, which is another application that we're coming to review on here at the end. It's like it has very basic Standard Note abilities, but Standard Notes has a lot more theming, a lot more extensions that you can take a lot further. I'm gonna skip ahead to Standard Notes. This is a great application in my opinion. I think this is doing really well, especially at the privatization of your data, securing it. So I'm gonna put it in amazing, hover it over great then, but actually I think it definitely deserves to land in amazing. It's a really well put together application. They've got a 5-year plan as well in terms of a 5-year pricing plan, which is something that Rome actually has, but I think I really like this application in terms of keeping it secure and keeping your data. I think they've really narrowed themselves down. Same goes to Dynalist. I'm always impressed with Dynalist, but I'm gonna put it in a good category. I think that the application is really well put together. What I particularly like about it is the fact that they've sort of built Obsidian based on the learnings from Dynalist, because they're from the same company. Dynalist is definitely one of those tools that if you see a pro user use it, or somebody that knows how to use it or they've learned over time, you definitely see the benefit of the application. I just really like the style of it. It's very similar to Workflowy. As we're talking about Workflowy, we'll pop Workflowy in good as well, because I think they're on similar par, Dynalist, Workflowy. If you're looking for an outliner, both of those two are good options. Next up is one that I actually haven't checked out properly yet. I've got an interview coming up with the chaps who are there. I'm excited for it, and I'm just gonna put this one in good because from what I've done from my research, it's a good application, and they're sort of creeping on the Rome for students market, which I think's a good market to go into, especially when you get students that are heavily invested in research and study and want to be able to use the bi-directional linking, and that could be a good bet for them to be placed there. So very impressed with what I've seen of the application so far, and I follow Red Gregory. She puts together some great overviews of the application. Now, I'm gonna leave Apple Notes last because I want to share my opinion on it. But Zoho Notes is also one that I'm always impressed with. I'm gonna put it in great. I don't know whether this is a new logo or not, but it is very similar to what the logo was before. I think I saw it and I was like, yeah, they must have had a logo upgrade. It's a great application because they continue to refine it. It's also free if you've got a Zoho account, and it's got some small features like Web Clipper. I would call it Google Keep on really effective Google Keep. I was going to say on drugs, but I didn't know whether I should say that or not. But I think Zoho Notebooks definitely on the great category. And finally, we have Apple Notes. And this is actually one that the reason I want to talk about it is because it adds stuff to it every single year that is great. But in the end, I think we'll all probably be using some form of Apple, Google, or Microsoft software for our experience, just because I think they have the lead in the experience of the artificial intelligence, and I don't think other productivity applications will. So I think they obviously give them the advantage. Apple Notes, Apple Reminders, we could all be, due to their artificial intelligence abilities in the future, be using all these applications, and we would forget about all the other productivity in the market. Whilst I'm not going to rate it based on that, I definitely think still people should make a note of that. I'm gonna put it in average, of course. So that's my lineup there. Amazing, Obsidian, Standard, Great, runs from NotePlan, Agenda, Nimbus, Bear, Notion, Rome, and Zoho. Good is Ample Notes, again, still impressed with. Evernote, Dynalist, Workflowy, and RemNote. In average and NAF go OneNote, Keep, Apple Notes, and SimpleNote. So guys, I hoped you enjoyed that overview. I've probably missed a couple of them. Let me know which applications I've missed in the comments below. I'd love to hear your opinion. You can do this same thing that I'm doing on I think there's a link that I'll include that you can do it. You can download all of the apps I've mentioned as well in the description below. But a big thank you for stopping by today, and I hope they had a bit of a laugh. I'm gonna be doing this with calendar applications, email applications, habit trackers, crikey, maybe even other apps outside of that as well, to help give you my opinion on these tools. So guys, a huge thank you. I hope to see you all very soon, and look forward to reading some of your comments. Make sure to subscribe, and I'll talk to you all very soon. Cheerio.